Bye, lady. Oh, she really had to leave. Had to leave that thing.
Hey guys, so I uploaded the video about my W9 the other day. I never really got into the story of why I bought it, what I plan on doing with it, and pretty much everything I plan on doing with it. But I think some of you guys might have some questions of, like, just what's the backstory behind it. And so I was scrolling on Facebook, and I'll put the link into Facebook here.
Fuck everybody but me, everybody but me. Looking like it's all good, but fuck everybody but me. Everybody but me.
Feeling good.
Everybody but me, say fuck everybody.
Okay. We drinking, why you wonder why your woman winking? Trip with us, you're headed for extinction. We just bringing Brinks in to buy the bar, get everybody drinking. People looking salty, must be smoking Jesse Pinkman. Everybody but me, looking broken, dusty. That's how your lady look at me, that's why she wanna cuff me. I'm gonna shine, never rusty. Every year I come back with another one, they never gonna hush me. She wanna get close to touch a strange gem. She say, you don't remember me cause I just became slim. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. That's right, I know you from, so and so, what's the name them? They know that Technina's always coming hotter than Hell's Pit. And I'm steady drinking like I'm a Celtic. Why they tripping with me? Cause now I'm dipping with she, and I'm gonna give her what she need, pelvis.
Walk right up in the room like fuck everybody but me. Everybody but me. Looking like it's all good, but fuck everybody but me. Everybody but me. And I really wish a nigga was.
And basically I was scrolling on it, I saw it. It was gonna be like my entire life savings. And so my wife and I put everything we had together and we went out and sent the guy a message, said, hey, I'd like to come pick it up this weekend. And we went to the bank, got the cash. Left out, it was about 5 hours away. So we left at like 10 in the morning and went to the bank, got the cash out, and then left and headed to Chicago, or right outside Chicago. And got the truck, got there about 6 o'clock at night. It's everything exactly that I wanted. It's exactly all of the, exactly the project I wanted. I know it's not a perfect truck. It's gonna be another 6 months to a year spending, going through it and fucking really making it mine, painting the frame and everything. So like I said, I'll drop that video there and then I'll even get into more of the details and stuff like driving the truck home. We went and picked it up. Everything was great. I made it about a half a mile out of the driveway and the truck started doing this. I knew what sensor it was because it doesn't have any lights going off. Temperatures, everything's good. I think it's an air gauge because they've converted it from a single gauge over here to a dual gauge up here, and that sounds like a low arrow buzzer to me, but who the fuck knows. I'll get a computer and figure out. It's either that or it's like a low coolant sensor. It's about a gallon low. I put a gallon in it and I didn't seem to change much. It randomly comes and goes. When it comes, it cuts power about 10-15 seconds after it starts beeping, it cuts power. And it's right before it stops beeping, it'll fucking come back alive. Or really 500 speedometer too, it's doing 55. It cuts it back to 55. So obviously it's dinging its head off and I'm like sick to my stomach. I haven't been an owner operator in a couple of years, so I was like, man, I don't have the money to tow this thing home. 5 hours away from the house, and it's dinging, it's derated to 55 miles an hour, and so I drove it for about 2 hours, 3 hours left to go, and I posted on Facebook on the W900 forum, and I was like, hey, does anybody know this noise? And everybody is right there trying to help me out. I'm like, these guys got it. You know, my last truck, well, here's a picture of it. That was my first over-the-road truck that I bought. It wasn't my first over-the-road truck. My first over-the-road truck was here. Here's a picture of it. It's a 2008 2007 W9, but the first truck that I bought was a 96 Peterbilt, and it was rough, it was hard, it didn't have air conditioning, didn't go over well. You know, I learned a lot. That's why this truck, I want to get it, and I'll just put it right to work. I'm going to put all new airbags and stuff on it. I want to get the air conditioning fixed. Just any type of thing, airlines, tires, oil change, transmission fluid change all the different fluids, any maintenance stuff, get that done first. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to give you the getting it home and stuff. So after those guys posted what was the issue, I shut the radio off, and here, yeah, I might have a couple of clips and videos and pictures and stuff of the trip home here. Oh shit, easy girl. Fuck, it's like driving a goddamn, it's like I got my pup trailer back there with 300 fucking inch wheelbase. I thought my 295 was, well, I thought, I'm starting to think my 295 was a fucking 285, or this is a fucking 305. Taking off like a rocket, boys. Fuck it, let's get her going. Nah. But I got it home, and that's where the next video, you know, video number one comes from, so we'll be like one behind. This is actually video number two. Man, coming in hot there, right? He don't care. He ain't loaded. I guess he doesn't know how you work. The fuel island goes the other way, but that is what it is. Yeah, it's definitely coming from up above. The only light that I have on up there is an ABS. And when it goes off, I get power back. I'll flip the key here real quick. Guys, it's no longer making that noise. It definitely has low voltage issue, but if I shut the radio off, it doesn't draw the voltage down too much now. So I'm only 45 minutes away from home, Chicago to Chillicothe, Missouri, on batteries alone, and what little bit the alternator is doing.